very busy intersection downtown New York City. Well, sure enough, on time, on schedule, 24 bass players showed up lugging their instruments to this intersection in downtown New York City. Joe was watching from a restaurant window just inside, laughing at him. But he felt so bad about it, he went out and paid all the guys the regular price for having shown up. Moon Glow, Benny Goodman, the quartet. I love the Benny Goodman Orchestra, I love the quartets. Goodman gets a lot of credit, conservatively, for helping him integrate big band music. The important thing to understand is that he was not an intentional civil rights activist by any means. Goodman was very serious about his music. And for him, he was selecting the very best players he could find. Period. That was it. He explained to Lionel Hampton once, he said, Goodman said this, he said, if a guy's got it, let him give it. I'm selling music, not prejudice. And as a result of that, the Goodman Quartet, of course, would be formed with Goodman on clarinet, Ed Wilson on piano, Lionel Hampton on vibes, which struck a lot of people. Vibes in a big band on a quartet, boy, did it fit in. That leaves one fourth person who was the star player for Goodman's big band for a lot of years on drums.
Gene Krupa.
What a personality and what a talent on drums. Well, let's hear the Nancy Clayton Big Band version of this wonderful song, Moonlight.
Thank you. I think I put in too many vocals on this first set. My song is better.
Jack and the Joe.
Titles and titles. The spectrum is a good one.
Good for a wedding.
The ladies and friends.
I get that request for songs for weddings. I was a puzzle.
Listen, all they're talking about is they're talking about a lady who has no interest in material things.
You do.
What's that? No interest in material things. Again, associated with a lot of people, especially Tommy Dorsey. Terrible times. What a temper. Tom and his brother Jimmy came out of Dusty, Pennsylvania, coal fields. A lot of these band leaders came up poor. They were very ambitious. Tommy was absolutely determined to be successful and bring a lot of money. And he did. He made a lot of people mad on the way up. But he made a lot of people on the dance floor extremely happy. He's a very popular man. Dorsey was after inspection. He was settled for anything less. He and Jimmy, his brother, started out together as the Dorsey Brothers Orchestra. But it wasn't going to last. They didn't get along very well, and they were very different. And so the story goes, on one occasion that Tommy was leading and Jimmy was in the saxophone section. He was sitting on the aisle. And I'm going to start this number, and Tommy laid off, and Jimmy said, hey, Buck, don't you think that's a little fast? And Tommy looked at him and mentioned some things we can't say here, walked off the stage, and that was it. Split the band up, they went their separate ways for most of their careers, and Tommy and his demand for perfection went through, incredibly, 250 personnel.
Wow.
If he took it this high for you and your playing, you were gone in the middle of the performance and you played to somebody else. Hard to work for, but oh, the music. Some of the best music guys we've been there came out of his band. They can do anything, from the sweet to the swing. And this next number, I think you'll be able to classify it, as you hear Nancy and the lady is a tramp.
Yeah.
tied too close to her, and she'd leave him, and he'd be forced to go over there. They wanted to see a way to do something else. So they said, okay. So they paired him with Joan Fontaine in a movie called Damsel in Distress. They lost money. But if you're an old movie fan like me, go ahead and look that one up, because it's really a delightful film. In addition to the two I mentioned, there's also George Burns and Tracy Allen. And that made it a kind of a wacky film all of its own, and most enjoyable. Anyway, in this film, he's singing this to Joan Fontaine. And this title, Nice Work If You Can Get It, sometimes people think of it in terms of, gosh, I wish I'd been in a big band back in that period. It would have been wonderful, it would have been exciting and glamorous. Like the role that these guys are having today. If you've been in a big band back in the 30s, most of the time you spent touring. And you weren't touring in one of these big luxurious vans that you see going down the highway. It was in a kind of a rickety old bus, and they were traveling one-night stands. And usually the distance between the one-night stands was incredibly long, requiring that the guys frequently had to sleep on the bus, and they'd pull in, try to wake up, try to put their clothes in some sort of order going to make the engagement. And then food, wherever they could find it, and it usually wasn't very good. And if they were lucky, they wound up perhaps in a cheap hotel for the night, but more likely to be back on the bus headed for the next engagement. And yet they did it. And they probably did it for the same reason these guys are here today at night. Because they love music. And I think you can tell it by the quality of the music we're hearing tonight. Am I right?